clutch slave cylinder is out as well. It's gonna be hanging around. Power steering is off. Power steering pump. So pretty much close to being able to pull it out. Still need to do the heater, coolant pipes, and detach all the electrics, wirings. Oh yeah, of course the fuel lines as well. Had to butcher these coolant lines. They're quite old and really hard and stuck on there. I just cut them off and remove the rest afterwards, maybe. So, because I'm probably gonna delete this PPF, the diff is gonna be hanging on, so I'm gonna have to build some sort of a bracket to probably mount it to the subframe somehow, weld it. But I kind of need a reference for the actual position of the diff, the flange, input flange. So I'm gonna measure roughly this distance in order to get some sort of an idea where it should be. I have mounted the PPF the back and in the front, so it should be at normal height. So it's about 85 mils, something like that. Of course, there's a ground strap holding everything. not too bad. Only thing I had attached was this ground strap. Apart from that, kind of came out okay-ish. The engine gearbox assembly are quite long. To be honest, it was a bit annoying, but it's out now. And now this is what I'm gonna work with. The subframe is probably gonna need a bit of a trim. And maybe the sides there. We'll see once we get the M54 in there. Alrighty then. So then we have the two engines side by side. First actual measurement to see the overall size of it. If you have a look, the front of the MX-5 have the water thermostat. Looks like it. It's kind of sticking out a bit compared to the crank pulley. On the Beamer, it's pretty much flush, so should be better for the radiator and the fan. On the back, we have this coil pack sitting here on the back of the engine, and the actual block and gearbox plane, whatever you call it, it's over here, which is quite quite a lot of distance between this and this, and this is pretty much the limiting factor in the engine bay. If you look at the Beamer, that again it's pretty much flush to this limiting face. That should help with packaging. Biggest issue I'm worried about is this big ass sump compared to this one. That's why we're gonna do a few basic measurements. So the overall length of the engine, I would say to fit in the engine bay, it's like I don't know, let's say 60-65-ish centimeters. For the Beamer, just a tad longer. Look somewhere around 72-73 compared to 65-ish, which is not too bad. And then I would like to measure this sump length, this bottom part, but should be, I think, compared to the furthest point in the back, which is this, and just a bit of by eye engineering here, maybe let's say 30 centimeters. And on the Beamer, we're gonna have to measure it from this, basically. So it's pretty decent, to be honest. That's about 30 centimeters, which is quite decent. That's my logic here. Looks like should be alright. Then we have the engine mounts positions. That being straight six, they're a bit forward, but they are curved and they come backwards a bit, so pretty sure I'll find a solution. There are plenty of threaded holes here. I can bolt to almost any of those and put a big plate there and weld the mount on there. Anyway, it's not too bad, but looks quite promising from this first measurement, but gonna have to slide it inside soon enough. I'm gonna take this out, put it somewhere there, and gearbox, and make some room for the Beamer engine in the front so I can work. And yeah, that's gonna be for sale. If somebody's interested, give me a message.